Look like profile my display, advanced, 120.
Hey, hey, Jordan here, and it is good to see you. Welcome back to another video. Today we are talking about calibrating your monitor using this guy right here. I've got him plugged in. I'm gonna show you exactly what to do on your screen. This isn't sponsored, they didn't send it to me. I went and bought it myself because I need to make sure that my photos look good no matter where they are. Esther Ziegler, a friend of mine, introduced me to this because she loved it so much. And ever since she did earlier this year, I have been hooked. Step one, buy a calibration device. Now, there are tons that you can choose from. You can choose, you know, you can spend anywhere from like $50 to $2,000. I happen to go with something a little over 100. I personally don't need a $2,000 calibration device right now when my $100 one works. I don't know if it works anymore. When my $100, little over $100 monitor calibration thing works just fine. As long as you don't throw it, I think it'll work. I don't think this is how it's supposed to go. I need to fix this the most seconds. Just don't throw it and you should be fine. Should be all good. It works. It popped back together. For it, see, you snap it up and turn it like this all the way to the other side. And then when you're using it on this side, you need to pop it back down. And I have a blog post for you on this down below in the description. I actually published that last week and then got this question from Erin. She said, "Hi, I've been reading all about calibrating, but wonder, do you need to calibrate when you have a Mac 5K retina screen? I mean, it's supposed to be made for photography, right? But my images never look the same on my phone and are almost always too magenta. Would love to hear your thoughts." Yes. When you open up a retina display, it looks fantastic. The colors pop right off the page, the screen. It looks almost larger than life, but it messes with your editing. So it is not all in your head. You're seeing the right thing that you're not seeing the right thing. This ColorMunki display will do the trick in getting your monitor back on track. Step two, install the software. This device actually came with a CD where you insert it, load the program, and it installs. I didn't do that, I just Googled. My Mac doesn't have a CD holder for one, but also it's just easier to Google and download the product directly from the site. But the only catch is that it's super easy for people to hack you if you download it from the wrong site. So make sure that wherever you get your device, you download from the person you purchased the device from. Does that make sense? And then I got another question from Erin of Willow Creek Studios. Where did you get it? I wanna calibrate and make sure it's not funky, LOL. Well, you and me both, Erin. I got it on Amazon and I'll link it down below in the description. Step three, plug your device in and choose advanced photo. There are a lot of options in here. So you can choose between regular photo, advanced photo, and even some video options, but I always just leave mine on advanced photo. Step four, set the display luminance to 120 or let ColorMunki decide it for you. I like leaving it at 120. I've messed around both ways. I kind of feel like letting ColorMunki decide it for me throws my screen off just a smidge. And I am sure that's because in my office, the light's changing a lot. I live in Missouri, so the sun is constantly going behind the clouds and it's bright and sunny. So maybe that has something to do with it. So I like just leaving it at 120 and going from there. Step five, check both of these boxes. I do this because I want the device to check for the light around me and any glare that's happening on my screen. And I have my computer turned away from the windows for this exact reason, but there's still a little bit of a glare. And ColorMunki always detects it, and then it can adjust for you based on whatever glare is happening on your screen. Step six, put your device down in front of your computer, somewhere where it can get a good perspective on what the room, how bright your room is. I like to keep mine on this side since this is the side I'm working from. You point the lens thing toward the white thing. Technically, it's described as placing the, quote, ambient diffuser over the instrument piece. Just put the white part over the lens part. That's all it is. While we wait for that to finish, Abigail asked, where do you create your images for your blog? Okay, so I just released this in my last video, but I use blog sets. So you can get them at blogsets.com. They are modern blog post templates for modern bloggers. So you just drag your images in, print a file that's your AKA like export, and then you upload those image sets to your to your site. So they're sized at 900 pixels. They work great. And don't forget, you can use YouTube 50 for 50% off. But we're just gonna make this video sponsored by Blog Sets. This video is brought to you by blogsets.com. Get your blog post templates, import them into Lightroom, and start blogging the modern way today. Once it's done measuring, you'll get a green check. If you get something that's yellow, you need to read the message and possibly put your calibration device in a different spot. But for here, it looks good. So we'll click next. Step 7, keep following the prompts on the screen. Measure the ambient light, flip the white part to the back, and put the device on your screen. Flip this around, so we pop it on the top and rotate it so that the lens isn't covered anymore. Use the weight to keep the device on your screen. Tilt your screen back as far as it will go to make sure there's no space between the device and the screen. Then we'll hang this over the computer with the lens positioned right on the screen. And we'll tilt the screen back. Make sure you position it so that there are no gaps between the lens and the screen. Step 8, adjust your screen's brightness. So you can do this by, on a Mac, just clicking, you know, less bright, brighter. If your screen doesn't have this option, ColorMunki says you can just skip this step. But the idea is just to get it as close as possible. You don't have to get it exact. You probably won't be able to get it exact. So just get it as close as possible and then click next. Step 9, make a coffee, read the Magnolia Journal, create some content while you wait for about 5 minutes for your screen to calibrate. Elizabeth asks, what is the D plus under the ISO in your view box? This is indicating that I have highlight tone priority turned on my camera. I leave it on always, unless I'm shooting double exposures, in which case my camera makes me turn it off. So, but then I always turn it back on because I love highlight tone priority. People have very strong opinions about this thing. I love it, I love it. Step 10, measure the glare. Hold the device about a foot away from your screen and point it at the screen. This is the last step, and the difference it makes is slight, but if you're printing from your computer, it's a must. Step 11, save the profile. I like to save it according to the date that it was created. So this one would be September 2nd, 2019. It helps me keep it organized, and then also, you can also create one for when you're editing at night. You can have a nighttime calibration and a daytime calibration. You can have an overcast, a sunny, coffee shop, you know, whatever it is, wherever you're working, whatever situation you're in, just customize it so that it works with your workflow. But you could work it into your Monday morning routine or your Friday workday shutdown routine. You know, whatever it is, just make sure you're doing this weekly to keep it updated. At least that's what I do, and it works really well so far, as long as you don't throw it. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like down below, comment, you know, or a dislike if that's your favorite thing to do. It's whatever. And don't forget, you can subscribe for more awful videos just like this one. Share your work, pull the trigger. Do not hold back on sharing your work on Instagram, on your blog, on your website. Go update that stuff. Go make new things. You know, whatever it is that sets your heart on fire, go and do more of that this week and share it. Share it with the world. Cheering you on big time, and I'll see you in the next video.